the after effects of web is finally here. Before, when you had to do these types of effects, it required a lot of 3DS, WebGL knowledge, and R3F to make it possible. There was a no-code solution that was offered before. You might have spline or different 3D elements that you could do, but not these types of effects that you could do easily. That's also very lightweight. And so as you can see, you have so much effects here, and I'm so excited to dive into this. It has a really easy interface. It's super easy to learn. It's super easy to use. There's so much things that I want to uncover into this. Let's jump right in. As you can see, I've done so much projects already inside of this platform. Let's try to view one. So as you can see right here, you know, those Instagram things that we had back then in 2016, these types of effects, you got to render it inside of Cinema 4D, put them with a reflective thing over here with some person here. And so you could do this live, and it's faster even than After Effects. You could also do these types of effects, solar flares. As you can see, this is actually live. This is WebGL, this is 3JS. And so the effects that I have here are pretty much live. Okay, and so much things that we can uncover and we could do. We can even do animations like this, as you can see, Pinterest type stuff. Like you could do that internally here. Before, I used to do that in Photoshop, animate with all these things. But the most amazing part here isn't just that you could do it fast, is that you can upload this into your website as if they are actually interactive elements. And it's very, very quick and very, very small and very, very fast to load. And so I really like this, because as a guy who's been watching Andrew Kramer for my whole teenage years, I've mastered After Effects. But when I moved into web, a lot of those was applied towards Lottie, and Lottie is more animation based rather than actual effects that we do inside of After Effects. So as you can see, we even have this type of effect, hologram effect, and you could do this before with Element 3D. If you know, you know. It's that simple. Look at that. So right now we will jump in, because I'm so excited to show you what this thing could do. So in this first project that we're going to do this, what you call an FBM. You call it FBM here in Unicorn, but in After Effects, you would consider this as a fractal noise, right? And so there's lens distortion here, really good dispersion. It was really hard to get chromatic aberration in After Effects before, but here it's so easy and it damn looks good. Imagine if you could put this as a background on your website. Think about that. So let's head back and create a new project. First things first, of course, you have to make your background black. And you want to do the interactions first, which will be a light trail. So as you can see right now, we have this light trail. We can change the radius to something bigger so that we got that there. We can change turbulence to maybe it could be basic, just a tad. We could make it real high. We don't need no, yeah, we could do lots of color mix. Look at that. That's amazing. A little bit of bloom. There we go, turbulence more. And you could just try and experiment on this one. And so let's just say that we are good with that. The next thing that we would do is just add an FBM, which just makes it done. Like, look at that. That's so simple. And we've done so much before. When you have to do this in After Effects, you're going to be doing a lot. It's similar to the lightning tutorial that Andrew had before, wherein you'd be putting a fractal noise and then you'd be putting some lightning effects, right? And so this one, you've already got it. Goodness sake. Look at that. It's so beautiful. Maybe we can make the tail a little bit longer so that it lasts longer. There we go. Yeah, there we go. That's spreading. And then we can change the FBM to maybe play it out so it's more randomized. Wow, look at that. We could lower down the scale so it's a little bit more smoky, or make it higher. There we go. Wow. Octaves, there we go. Gain, we could put the gain high. There we go. So it's more smoky now, right? And then phase. Yeah, pretty much it. You know, we can higher and lower the drift. Boom. So there's lots of things you could do with this effect. The next thing that would make this cooler is simple enough. You could do a lens distort effect here. Boom. Wow. It's already looking damn good. So already, once I start putting this and move it around, we could also see the effect already there. And so it's as simple as that. We can change this higher. Put that dispersion up. As you can see, it looks damn good. One thing that I want to add in this design before I export this is adding what you call glow inside of Webflow, but here it's called bloom. You know, you don't want to release an effect without any glow, right? And so we would put the radius up, maybe the intensity down, and the threshold maybe high. And as you can see, maybe a little bit more right there. As you can see, that's a big difference, right? Imagine putting this in your website, right? What if you want to adjust the contrast, right? Well, in the hue, well, you could just move it around with this one. As you can see, change. You could put more saturation. It's as simple as that. You have the HSL that you have inside of After Effects, and you already have it here. So if you really like your design already, in order to export this, you just click on export, and then you could change this production because you're going to export already, which means that it's ready for production, right? And so we're going to hit publish, and then we can hit preview and see what we've done so far. So now we have this part, right? And it looks damn good. We got all the effects here. You could put this into your website already. And there are ways that you could optimize this, really. You could do a lot more things in here, and I could do another tutorial. It's in our video into itself. We could do optimizations right here, and it's a new thing. You could change the scale settings. You could change the bloom, the output of the bloom, all this, da-da-da. Lots of stuff that we have to do, but we will uncover that into another tutorial later on. So there's already so much things that you could do inside of Unicorn Studio. You might have to keep an eye on this tool because lots of award-winning websites are already using this tool. I recently had a mentorship session with Nicolo Miran that a lot of my classmates were using this. I was using this. I'm gonna upload the project once I finish it into Webflow. But lots of us are being trained to use this already instead of using WebGL or 3JS or R3F, because the thing is, when it comes to design, it's about designing smarter so you could move faster using all these tools. I will be doing more comprehensive tutorials on this After Effects of the web, so stay tuned. Also, if you want to do the Apple Liquid Glass effect inside of Unicorn Studio, I have a video that I'm going to release right here, so check that out. With that said, let me know if you have any questions in the comments. Like if you like this video, subscribe so you can see more videos like this, and I will see you guys next time.